A Victorian inmate will walk out of prison tomorrow and into a debate over the length of sentences. Leslie Cunliffe was put away for kidnap, rape and torture, but he served just a little over half the original sentence. Here's 6.30's Maggie Palmer.
Kidnapper, rapist, torturer.
I brought the lass here, for the intention of keeping her here.
Leslie Cunliffe's crime, so horrendous, detectives likened it to a scene from a movie.
To me, it was something out of Silence of the Lambs. It was just bizarre.
The nightmare played out in Geelong in 1999. Posing as a police officer, Cunliffe abducted a 21-year-old woman at gunpoint. He held her captive in a shed, gagged, blindfolded and tied to a chair, a fake bomb strapped to her body.
Inside here?
Yep.
With the belts, but they're not there now, the belts were tied up around the bottom of the base and around her ankle.
She was raped and tortured. Eventually, she escaped.
She must have heard me and she started yelling out, "Help me, help me." And I said to her, "Where are you?" And she said, "I'm in the garage."
The purpose of the sordid attack was money. He sent a ransom note demanding $1 million. Friend Cameron Ling says neither the victim nor her family have been the same since.
She's a pretty strong girl and she's moved on as much as she can, but from something like that you can't move on completely.
The father of two was sentenced to 20 years prison. It was reduced on appeal. Tomorrow he walks free after just 12 years behind bars.
Hopefully the restrictions on him are that tight and that severe that they can get on with living their life without worrying too much.
He's not allowed to break the law or leave the state, but he won't be listed on the sex offenders register.
I mean, this guy is he's not a guy, he's a monster. And the parole board, you know, for letting him out the way they are, it's just so wrong.
The parole board says it's in the best interests of the community to release suitable offenders before the end of their sentence. But victims of crime support groups disagree.
They want the makeup of the parole board changed to give victims of crime a voice.
Well, I'd like to see it overhauled. Kick out the old guard there at the parole board and set up a new system with good people from the community to look after people coming out.
The Victorian Attorney General concedes something has to change.
At the moment, our sentences are not sending a clear enough message that serious crime will have serious consequences.
Little comfort to Leslie Cunliffe's victim, who from tomorrow will be haunted further by the knowledge that he's free.
Is he going to be around? Is something going to happen? And I don't think good people like that should have to live their life with that sort of doubt always being in their mind.